What's going on, guys? Danny Lanier Lawn Care. Today, we have got our hands on, and we're going to make plenty of videos about this, try to anyway. We've got our hands on the new FB1000 from Ferris, 3,500 plus CFM. This thing is just, you know, I did a video on it a while back. We're going to see what this is really made of. What better place than all of these leaves? But if we can't take care of it with this, well, we have something we can take care of it with. That is going to be a Buffalo turbine blower. If you watched last year, we'll show you this thing. This thing won't take care of it. Well, I promise you, this thing right here will take care of it, but there is a ton, and so we're really going to see what this is made of, because there are leaves everywhere.
right, guys, so let's talk about this machine. Let's go over some of the features of this, give you kind of a idea of what's going on, some of the pros, some of the cons, because everything has a con. So platform, very small platform. The platform can be lifted up in that up position, locked. Then you just have a lever here and you pull this lever up and the platform will drop down. When we talk about how to get to majority of your stuff, your hydros, things like that, this is running the ZT3100 hydros. So they are 100% completely serviceable. And in order to get to them, all you do is raise this back up. As you raise this back up, then you will notice that here are your hydros and things of that. So you can check your fluids and whatnot. We're going to lift this back down. Up here, pretty much all you have is a throttle, your choke, and your start. Then you have your hour meter. Now this has 8.8 hours on it as of right now. I have put probably a little over 6 hours, if not close to 7 hours, on this machine since I've had it the past 3 or 4 days. So this machine has gotten a lot of use with what I've been doing. You cannot adjust the speed of this like you can, you know, on a Z3X or something like that, where you have the adjustable front handle. So it's literally just get on, you can, you know, adjust your speed as you go. And so this is going to give you that 8 miles per hour travel speed for to get, you know, through these jobs a lot quicker than you would be able to in a walk behind. Now, one thing I do love about this unit is it's only 35 and a half inches wide. So with that being said, any of your properties that you have that 36 inch gate on, or maybe a lot of your properties are 36 inch, you got some with bigger backyards, you don't want to use that walk behind, well, you can grab this. And this is also going to help you great tremendously when it comes to blowing off them parking lots as well of your commercial units. Another great feature of this is you can face this toward the gate and you can take your blower or whatever and blow your leaves into the airflow of this and blow them right through that gate. So you unlock some of the, like the Skag Windstorm per se, you have a PTO on that, it's belt driven. So when you pull that PTO up, you ain't getting off that platform. Somebody has to always be on that platform, to where with the Ferris FB1000 or the 3000, not sure about the 2000, but you can get off the platform and easily use this machine. If you're a one man crew, well, this may be your next purchase. Let's move on up here. We'll turn this machine around, show you some more of these features. All right, so moving on up, we have our 18 horsepower Vanguard engine. Now I will say this engine is very, very powerful for this small of a unit. It did very, very well, as you can tell from the video. It truly amazed me of how well it actually did. Now I haven't got to use the FB3000 this year, so I really can't compare too much. But I do know that the FB3000 is significantly, 2 times plus what this is, but for how small and compact this unit is, it really puts out a lot of power. So when they say like dynamite comes in small packages, this thing is a small package, but it will totally amaze you at how much it can do. Now let's get to some of these cons, and then we'll move up to the front here and we'll go over another, what you could consider a con per se. This handle is all metal right here, that's for your brake. And I wished I would have personally like to have seen something rubberized, even a little bit of rubber or something around this handle, to give us a little bit more feeling than straight metal. But that could be, I mean, that's not going to be a deal breaker for most people. They can always take something and put around it. But the problem, it lies in the fact of me personally, when I'm looking at a machine and I'm looking at a $9,000 unit for something like this, Well, it's the small things that matter as well. I mean, yes, it's productive. Yes, time is money. Yes, it's going to save me a lot of time to make extra more money, but still the small things I really, really enjoy that just steps companies apart from other companies, in my opinion. So this would have been nice to have a rubberized handle on. Let's get to the biggest con I've got is this fuel tank right here. This fuel tank don't have a clear window. It has no fuel gauge, no nothing. So you never know how much fuel you got. You fill it up and you run in a couple hours. You're constantly checking in, you know, probably every hour or so if you're running it a lot. And, you know, I mean, I kind of get it because you are going from property to property. You could check it, you know, between properties, but I'd much rather have a gauge to know what I've got fuel wise without having to keep constantly opening this up, getting, you know, leaves or trash or whatever's blowing around and take the chance of getting something in here and clogging it up. So even with a fuel window or something on the side of this, the back side, you can clearly see the back side of this tank. Why not give us a clear window on this? If you're not going to give us a fuel hand, a fuel gauge, at least give us the window to where we can look down and see around about how much fuel we've got left to where we don't run out. Because I will tell you, Danny's clumsy and Danny ran out. But I filled it up, didn't have any problem starting it whatsoever because this does have the fuel pump on it. So, I mean, you know, unlike some units out there that you're going to kill and then, you know, it could be real hard to get back started. I had no issues getting this started whatsoever, but I did run it out of fuel, and this was one of my biggest cons with this machine was that I didn't have any gauge whatsoever. So take that as you will. To some of you, this may be huge. To some of you, whatever, I can check it. Let's get to this blower part. Now this thing, over 3,500 CFM, and I'm going to tell you, it's an animal. It's just a small animal is what this thing is. But I will tell you also, if you're standing on this unit and you're blowing out the left side over here, let's say the left side blows at 100%, you're getting good airflow. Even if you have this one over here, the right side, the same, exactly all the way open, whatever the case may be, and you switch it to this right side, well, the problem lies is I give that side 100%. I'm just estimating here, but take it as you will. I would say that you're gonna get about 75% of that blowing power out of this side. So if that side's blowing at 100%, this side is gonna be blowing at about 75 once you switch it over. I'm not sure if that's because of the way the blade in here runs or spins. If it spins this away, then you know, of course, you would think that with it spinning this away, it don't have that conjunction to make that turn to come back out this side like it does or over there like it does over here. So, but just to fair warn you, that side over there, the left side, does blow significantly harder and farther than this right side. Like I said, it's probably a 25% difference, 20 to 25% difference in my personal opinion. But other than that, that's pretty much it. That sums it up. This machine has did absolutely great. It saved me a lot of time from using a backpack blower or having a walk behind because I don't have to walk and then pull it backwards or whatever the case may be. This thing is also more CFM, more miles per hour, things of such of that nature. So if you're looking for something small, compact with a lot of power, call your local Ferris dealer and see if they can't get you a demo of one of these or get a rep in your area to see if they can't bring you a demo to try one of these, because I think you'll highly be impressed with this unit as I was. Needless to say, I was used to the Skag Windstorm and there were a lot of things I wish I could have reviewed on that that I didn't, but there's things I like about it, there's things I don't like about it, but well, that's for a whole nother video. So I want to say thank you, my Ferris rep, for bringing this out to me to use and give y'all my honest thoughts and opinions on this and get you some footage of it, because it was absolutely wonderful with some of the cleanups I had to take care of. So that's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.